Did you know an increase for blockchain developers in demand is going up between 300 and 500% yearly? That seems like a lot of demand for blockchain developers. And the best part is, well, the best part for developers anyways, is it's very, very understaffed. There are a lot of companies who need blockchain developers, who need this talent, and there's just not enough of them. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you how to become a blockchain developer in 2022. We are going to be talking about what programming languages you should know, what steps to take, what really is a blockchain developer, and so much more. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Give this video a thumbs up and let's just jump right into it. I also want to give a huge shout out to our sponsor of this video, Appify. Appify is essentially like your one-stop shop for everything, for automating everything from web scraping, data extraction, and web RPA. Appify is one of those tools that I actually used when I was, well, I've used throughout my career, but one of the first times I used it was when I was in a coding bootcamp and I needed to make an API. And one of the great things about Appify is you essentially can turn any website into an API. They also offer web scraping, web automation, and web integration. So it's your one-stop shop. They offer hundreds of ready-to-use tools for marketing, machine learning, lead generation, etc. And the best part is, all ready-made scrapers have a free trial. One example of Appify is with machine learning, so you can actually generate large-scale datasets from the web for training of your artificial intelligence models. And as a developer, you can build your own scrapers and automation tools using the Appify SDK, an open-source, full-featured Node.js library for web scraping and automation. And you can also earn extra income by renting out the tools you develop for others to use in the Appify store. So it's kind of a win-win. You're developing things, but you also get paid by others for them to use it. I have linked Appify down below, so make sure to go sign up for free. You will also get $5 USD in usage credits every month without any credit card needed. And if you need an upgrade, I got you. You can use the code TiffinTech20 for a discount code of 20% off. Before we can really get into how to become a blockchain developer, we need to know exactly what is a blockchain developer. Now, this might sound obvious to some of you, and others of you might be really curious as to what this role entails. So I really want to go through it to make sure we all have a good understanding of what exactly it is. The role of a blockchain developer is very highly paid and involves designing, developing apps and solutions based on blockchain technology. Now, there are so many different routes you can go with blockchain development and areas you can specialize in. We're not going to necessarily go through that today, but rather the steps to take in order to get your feet into becoming a blockchain developer. Also, it's important to note, people often associate blockchain development or blockchain in general right with cryptocurrency. And yes, that's a huge use for blockchain, but it's not its only purpose. Blockchain can record digital transaction of, yes, cryptocurrency, but also data and other information. Another example of where blockchain technology could really be used is healthcare. If you want to keep track of healthcare records and ensure they are unique. I have in front of me here the Blockchain Academy report for 2021, and some of these statistics about blockchain development really blew my mind. I knew it was really in demand and roles were growing that way, but I didn't realize just how much. So I'm going to read some off for you, and I'll link the whole report down below, so if you're interested, you can continue reading it. Some of the things that they are stating for facts include blockchain developer with an increase of 33 times is the most emerging job since 2020. It's amazing. Also, blockchain is at the top of the list when it comes to the top 10 hard skills in 2020 based on a LinkedIn report. Big companies are using or will be using blockchain-based systems in optimizing processes. And then it talks a little bit about salary, but that always varies based on company and where you are located. In this report, it says the average annual income in the US for a blockchain developer is $136,000. Followed by $87,000 in Asia and $73,000 per year in Europe. That can vary greatly based on what company you work for, how senior you are, etc. But that's some insight as to what blockchain developers really make and also to just how in demand they are. Okay, so we have an understanding now of what a blockchain developer is and just how in demand it is. But the next thing that I really want to bring your attention to is, why is blockchain even important? We keep on hearing about blockchain, keep on hearing these buzzwords, but what does it really do? How do we benefit from this technology? Blockchain helps the verification and traceability of multi-step transactions that need verification and traceability. So So anything, any transaction that is taking place that really needs to be A, verified, but also something that is traceable, something that is unique and can be, have a whole kind of, what is the word? Just follow each footprint it leaves behind. Also, another great thing about blockchain technology is that it can help contract management and audit the origin of a product. So it really is almost like a, I like to think of it as a fingerprint. It is unique and it is traceable. Okay, that brings me to, what programming languages do you need to know to become a blockchain developer? Now, of course, this will vary if you already are in a position where you are a blocked or you are a developer, just not blockchain developer, versus you have no coding experience and you want to become one. Obviously, if you have no coding experience and you're working your way towards a blockchain developer, it will take more time, but it definitely is possible. Some of the programming languages that you will need to know, the first one includes Solidity. And there's probably no surprise here. Solidity is the original smart contract development language, and it was developed by Ethereum. That's used for creating smart contracts and also different apps that are on a blockchain-based platform, such as Ethereum. So this is a must-know language if you want to become a blockchain developer. I have some games that I really like to learn Solidity. One was Space Doggos. It's a bit outdated, but I still think it's really worth looking into. I'll link it down below. And then also too, I use BuildSpace, as I've mentioned in a few of my other videos. They give some great Solidity courses and really made me really understand it. And once you go through building a few smart contracts with it, it's pretty simple. Another programming language that's very popular when you are a blockchain developer is C++. And it's used for many blockchain projects, including, of course, the infamous Bitcoin. With C++ though, it's not only helpful if you are looking to become a blockchain developer, but just any developer in general. It's one of those languages that has been around for so long and has stood the test of time. Another programming language that's very popular for blockchain developers is Python. And actually I have in my notes here, Python currently is the second most common programming language in the world, which I feel like I need to Google this. Is this actually true? Python is the second most, I don't know if this was me writing my notes at 2 a.m. or this is actually true. Okay, so right now in 2021 anyway, so last year it was rated number one and then Java number two. I guess it really depends on what site you look in, but essentially it's extremely popular and it's not going anywhere. And Python, just like C++, is one of those languages that you can transfer to so many different roles that it's just good to have those skills in general. Okay, and then we get into some other things, such as cryptography. So cryptography is fundamental to the blockchain. Almost every process uses some form of public-private key. Now, you don't need to necessarily be an expert in cryptography, however, you should understand the basics of cryptography and basic algorithms. There are some other coding resources that I will link down below if you are looking to really elevate or start your career as a blockchain developer. These are just some languages. I'm not saying go out and learn them all because that's definitely not the case, but have an understanding of what is in demand, what is popular, and then you can kind of choose from there where to start. For me, how I chose where to start was simply by taking a tutorial on BuildSpace, building some different Solidity smart contracts, and kind of getting the basics of them figured out that way. And then from there, once I knew what the basics were and having that foundation, you can make more educated decisions on what language you want to learn next. Blockchain right now, there is a lot of hype around it and it can be easy to be, is this going to be something that's here to stay or go away? And I think that's one of my favorite things about it though, is being on the development side and learning about blockchain development is, you know, that portion of it is here to stay. Whatever, when you go into investing or cryptocurrency, it can go up and down and really all around. And that's up to you what you choose to do with that. But when it comes to building the blockchain, that's not going anywhere. And having these skills that are so in demand is, I think, really exciting, and it really excites me. That's why I'm spending so much of my time learning about blockchain development. At the end of the day, if you are looking to become a blockchain developer, start with a tutorial, start with Solidity, start with one of these tutorials that teach you how to build a smart contract and work your way up from there. It's really no different than if you want to become any developer. You just need to know what tools are used and then learn those tools. I hope this video was helpful in understanding what a blockchain developer really is, why blockchain is important, and also to some of the most popular languages around it, and also to some courses to take about it. Thank you all for watching this. Make sure to leave in the comments other videos you want me to see, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.